Hi, this is Jen Bentley, Dairy Field Specialist with Iowa State University Extension and Outreach, welcoming you to part one of our Beginning Dairy Farmer video series, featuring the Gibbs Dairy and the Confinement Freestall System they have chosen. Beginning farmers have various system options as they begin their careers, and the Gibbs picked their system because they felt they could best control the cow's diet and environment and best profit from dairy this way. So let's listen as Chris Gibbs shares his thoughts on their conventional dairy system.
My name is Chris Gibbs. We are in an operation Gibbs Dairy with my parents and my brother. We milk about 400 cows, crop about 1,000 total acres. We run about 250 acres of dairy quality hay, 650 acres of corn, and roughly 100 acres of beans. We run a De La Velle parlor, double 16, freestall barn. We run mattresses. I run mattresses sawdust on the milk cows, and dry cows are on sand. And calving area is just an open bedded area with a couple of maternity pens. We do run a cow manager heat detection rumination system, had that in place since roughly March of 2015. We chose the freestall parlor, the conventional style, we feel we can better maximize milk production per cow, better control heat abatement, and just overall management we feel is more at our fingertips, able to control, such as dry cows, for example. I like to control everything they eat. If they're on pasture, I feel like I don't have control. They do have an open grazing area, or an open exercise area, the dry cows do. There's some of the reasons we decided to go with a conventional system. Some of the challenges that we are presented with, as such as a lot of dairies, is a labor situation. Finding labor is getting very challenging. Other challenges are, extreme weather. Heat abatement, extreme hot and extreme cold are still very challenging. Reproduction. I feel like everything revolves around a pregnant cow. Try to set programs up for reproduction that nobody falls through the cracks, so to say. If they come up open on a herd check day, we get them on a system right away and follow through. And we push our preg rate. I love seeing mid-30s preg rate. We've added rumination in the last couple of years, which has been a very good positive for a fresh cow. Fresh cow transition and fresh cow management. We are averaging about one DA a year, and since we've put the ruminations in, I believe we've had two DAs in the last 18 to 20 months, which I think is incredible. We put rubber floors in the milk cow barn, has helped. It has assisted the heat detection system in picking up heats. The cows aren't afraid to ride anymore. It's more comfortable for them to show signs of heat. To maximize our forage quality, we are BMR corn silage. We've been BMR corn silage for 15 years-ish. We do a real good job of cutting on a good schedule on our forages. We invested a lot of money in our forage equipment, so if we have a short window, we were able to get things knocked out in a matter of 2 to 3 days. I think has paid big dividends in the last few years with the weather patterns we've been in. Facilities are can make a huge difference on production, calving issues, transition. This building right here, this maternity building, when we moved into here, my intakes, we picked up like 7 pounds of intake just moving into a new facility, but the old facility was very poor. Some of the positives this facility has made when we moved in is the transition is equated into higher milk production, healthier cow, better transition on the fresh cow. Reproduction has picked up. We still sell, I range between 20 and 40 milking cows a year we are selling for dairy purposes. And that is along with, we, you know, roughly a 30% cull rate. My goal is to have 50 to 60 beef crosses a year out of our low-end cows, I'm going to call them. Try to eliminate some of our lower lines with beef cross, just to market them off. We built this barn in 2011. Calves max out at about approximately 12 liters, I believe, of milk on the high end of their feeding program. We run a 52-day program. Calves are started outside in hutches for the first 7 to 10 days of life, and then moved in here. We probably average about between 21 and 22 months first calving, and prior it was pushing more like 24 months. Grain intake on the barn is one of the huge things we've seen. Grain in front of them all the time. It's not uncommon to see 8 to 10 pounds of grain intake on some of our 60-day-old calves in our calf barn anymore. Years ago, we used to look at if there was money in the checkbook. Now we try to look more along the lines of we invite some outside assistance on through Iowa State with what our return on assets, what kind of return on labor, so we can, you know, overall determine, you know, what are good investments and what returns on investments are. And we do use cost of production to determine profitability, because in the end, everything is the milk. Our paycheck is based on milk. We got to know what that cost, so we know where our benchmarks are. And some advice that I would give young people starting, or number one, surround yourself with knowledgeable people. Ask questions. I've been very fortunate with an excellent team throughout the years. Intensify on cow comfort. Intensify on forage quality. Start with good genetics on cows. Other advice would be work under somebody for some time, high production, good, well-run dairy. You learn what you can from the people that have already learned the hard way, so to say. You have to be committed. Commitment. You have to be committed to do it. You can't do a good job one day and the next day not. You have to do a good job every single day to continue to build and work towards your goal.